My name is Jason Elinoff. I'm a member of the Critical Care Medicine Department here at the National Institutes of Health. And right now we're in our 4D lab, which is our basic laboratory in the department. We are interested in investigating how the blood vessels within the lung change in patients who have very high blood pressure in their lung, what's referred to as pulmonary hypertension. And so we're interested in what causes these changes and what are newer options for treating patients with this disease. So I grew up, I guess, a relatively average kid. I went to public school, I went to public high school. My mother was an elementary school teacher, so I think in some respects her work ethic was what rubbed off on me the most. Maybe not the specific field, but the way she approached her job, her students, had a big influence on me. I guess I would say science became a prominent part of my life when I was in college. And I enjoyed my initial pre-med courses and so decided to major in chemistry. And so that's when I began doing laboratory work, experiments, and found it, you know, very enjoyable. And I can always find something new, something different that I did not know the day before when delving into the lab and either doing experiments or reviewing the literature. So I think the thing that I enjoy most is that sort of variety, that chance to ask questions. I get here in the morning. I am doing a combination of things in the lab. Some is cell culture work, where we investigate cells that are components of our blood vessels, that make up our blood vessels.
These are pulmonary artery endothelial cells. So these are the cells that we study that line the blood vessels in the lung and play a central role in producing disease in patients with pulmonary artery hypertension.
It's taking large databases, using some of our own experimental data to investigate new pathways that we are discovering in our experiments.
And which cell proliferation assay is this? So just tell me what you did here for the time of the treatment was.
So I used the new drug that we have and used low doses and treated for 12 hours only at this point, because I wanted to see the effect that it has early on.
Nice.
So I think it's not toxic at all.
We have patients that come here for their clinical care in addition to the research protocols that they're on. So we are our group offers specialty care in the field of pulmonary hypertension for these patients.
Hi, Barbara. This is Dr. Elinoff calling. Sorry to bother you. I just wanted to follow up on the test results we did last week after we made some changes to your medication.
Right now, the medications that treat patients with pulmonary hypertension predominantly work to relax the blood vessels or try to lower the pressure in the lungs. But we're beginning to learn that there are many other new important mechanisms that are likely causing disease in these patients. Things like targeting the inflammation or immune cells. Hopefully that will lead to patients actually seeing a cure of their disease as opposed to simply maintaining their functional levels. You know, look for opportunities either as a high school student or a college student to, come to the NIH or come to other places where you can contribute in a lab. There's a lot of programs that bring high school and college students to give them, you know, an upfront experience with what scientists do every day. And I think that just getting exposure to that with a scientist in a lab somewhere is the best first step.